So I'm Ben Peterson. I'm the aquatic noxious weed specialist for King County. And today we're here at Lake Rasmussen, a small lake here in Duval.
But no Egeria yet.
Egeria is an aquatic noxious weed. It lives down in the water.
Here's some.
It grows very aggressively. It can take over the whole water column.
This is the plant we're after.
It can take over the bottom of rivers.
Get a sample for Maggie.
So this weed was found here by a girl who at the time was a second grader and her mom.
This is what I found. I'm Maggie and I'm 8 years old. I just really like plants and animals, and I think some plants look super cool and they also do things to help with the world.
When the pandemic started, we started doing a homeschool curriculum, and she chose to do botany for her science. And we thought we'll do a little pond study and draw some of the plants, you know, that we see there and learn about them.
We got to study water plants. We came down here to look at them, and I walked over there and waded into the water a little bit, and I saw this plant that looked really cool with its spread of leaves and stuff.
She pulled some of the plants out and she said, "This looks like the plant in my book that it says it's Brazilian waterweed."
This one.
And we tried to identify it with this nature app.
So it kept telling us that it couldn't be Egeria because of our area.
And when we got home, we compared the picture and it really did look like it.
We found out that Brazilian waterweed or Egeria is a noxious weed.
She saw that there was an email address on the website and she said, well, we should just send them a picture of it.
It helps so much that she found that plant. Otherwise, we wouldn't have any idea it was here. Just 3 miles downstream is the Snoqualmie River, and if this plant were to get down there, it'd be really bad.
So she was very happy to hear we can keep it out of the river. I don't think she really understands like the magnitude of it.
I like knowing that I help.
It was hard to give up public in-person school, and homeschooling was something that we went back and forth about. And so it was nice to frame the pandemic in a positive way that, you know, she was able to make a positive impact on the community despite losing some things that she had been excited about. So, and I think she really wants to be a scientist and work with nature when she grows up. So that was also nice to kind of see, even as a kid, you can do a lot.